Hello again, everybody. Welcome to another edition of the SEMO Music and Arts Podcast. I'm here today with special guests, Roger Mattingly and his father, Duard Mattingly. These guys have been so kind to come over and play some music. We're going to tell stories and hopefully be entertaining. Maybe we'll learn a thing or two from Mr. Mattingly. Your dad is Mr. Mattingly.
Well, who am I then?
You're Roger. You are Roger, so without any further ado, let's do one, fellas.
What are you going to
play? All right, yeah. Do a little.
The warden led a prisoner down the hallway to his doom. I stood up to say goodbye like all the rest. And I heard him tell the warden just before he reached my cell, "Let my guitar play it, friend, is my request. Won't you sing me back home the songs I used to hear and make my own memories come alive? Take
Mattingly, this is going to be, I don't know if you understand how a podcast works. This will be on the internet, and there'll be lots of people listening to it. And basically, I'm going to throw some questions at you here and there. It's just like old buddies sitting down and talking. We just recorded. If you can believe it, in 2016, people want to hear people sit down and talk. And that's what we're doing. And we make a radio show out of it, but instead of the radio, it's on a computer.
Yeah.
So on this particular show, I like to talk about music. So if for the people listening, if you'd like to introduce yourself and kind of a little bit of your background, that'd be great. Just, you know, you want to get in the mic there.
Yeah, get up a little closer.
Yeah. Are you in home? Yeah.
You're good.
Okay. My name is Dirt Mattingly, and I'll soon be 92 year old. And
awesome.
I have played music and entertained since 1941.
A couple of years.
I have, not bragging, I have been on television. I was on Milton Berle's show in 1950 down at Memphis. And I was also on television out at one of the nursing homes here in Poplar Bluff. They came in and took a video of us singing and playing.
Now, you've been on stage with a few big artists too, haven't you?
Well, I guess you can say I've played with Little Jimmy Dickens, because he came out one night where we was playing.
Tell him where at.
At the Kennett at the East End Nightclub.
I'll be dang.
And he got up there on the stage and sang with us just like it was part of his job. So I guess I can say that I have played with him.
Now, who was that come in, the Blue Moon?
I played at the old Blue Moon in the early 60s, and Ray Price came by.
Oh, my goodness.
And I got him up to sing one, and the song he sung had harmony to it, and I knew the song, and so I stepped up there and started singing harmony with him. And he kind of backed up a little bit. He seen I could do it, so he just got right in there and went ahead and sang, and I sung harmony with him.
What song was that?
It was one of the first ones he'd come out with.
Do you remember the name of it?
Offhand, I don't remember what the first one was. But anyhow, we taken a break, and there was just three of us guys playing out there. And he said that he'd been in a lot of taverns in his life and everything.
Uh-huh.
He said us three guys was more professional than any place he'd ever been in his life, and
I'll
in bars.
Yeah. I'll be dang.
Especially the old Blue Moon.
Yeah, and 3 years ago, Roger, we was on Worldwide Internet.
Uh-huh. It was kind of a podcast they did for a Christmas show.
Yeah.
I'll be dang.
And they did it out to college.
Well, that's really cool.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of Ray Price, offhand, do you know of any old Ray Price songs?
Yeah, I know quite a few of them.
You know Crazy Arms?
Yeah, that was one of his songs.
Was that it?
Can we do that one right now? Do you mind?
Just talk.
What I'll do is I'm going to move that mic just like that, so the blue light's facing you there. There we go.
Good indeed.
Good indeed. All right.
Now, blue ain't the word for the way that I feel. There's a farm. This ain't no crazy dream, I know. while my yearning heart keeps saying you're not mine. My trouble mine goes soon to another you'll be with, and that's why I'm lonely all the time, and that's
So,
you don't have to hold that, you can just talk about it.
When you started playing guitar, did you learn by ear? Did you have lessons, or?
My daddy learned me three chords on the guitar. And I have played with guys, and I learned myself more or less than anything else. I'd come to where I knew there should be a chord in there, and I'd have the people, if I didn't know where it went to, I'd have the ones I was working with to show me what the chord was and everything, and that's why I started learning to play the guitar.
That's great.
And now, sometimes I pick up my guitar and I'll learn a new chord. I don't even know what it is, but it sounds good anyhow, so I put it in there.
Do you remember the first guitar you ever owned? Do you remember what brand it was? Or
it was a Sears and Roebuck.
Sears and Roebuck.
Yeah.
Now, was that electric or acoustic?
It was F sound hole, but it was acoustic.
Okay.
F sound hole. It wasn't electric.
That is neat.
I put a de-armored pickup on it.
Really? I didn't even realize DeArmond was around back then.
Yeah.
Do you remember the first song you learned all the way through?
Yeah, now this goes way back further than 1941.
That's all right.
Back in the late 20s, early 30s, my daddy had a group. He broadcast out of Perigeux, Arkansas. So they would practice at our house. Jimmy Rogers recorded the song in 1929. In 1931, I was singing it. I was 7 years old. I was singing with my dad at home there with that group and everything.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you still play that song?
I can, yes.
Would you mind doing that for us?
Well, I haven't done it in years. I'll have to think of how it starts off. After that, I'm all right. Just starting off.
You're right.
Riding on the eastbound freight train, speeding through the night. Hobo Bill, the railroad bum, was fighting for his life. The sadness of his eyes revealed the torture of his soul. He raised a weak and a weary hand to brush away the cold. Oh, 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 Billy. The bright lights flashed around him, no blankets there to fold. Nothing but the howling wind, the driving rain so cold. When he heard the whistle blowing in a dreamy kind of way, the hobo seemed contented, for he smiled there where he lay. Oh, boxcar door, the little form of Hobo Bill lies still up on the floor. As the train blasts through the and the stormy rain outside. The hobo, that hobo Bill, was making his last ride. Oh, hobo, Billy. It was early in the morning when they laid the hobo's head. Smile still lingered on his face, but hobo was dead. There was no mother's longing to soothe his weary soul, for he was just a lonely hobo who died out in the cold. Hobo Bill.
Yeah.
Well, they call him the yodeling hobo, right?
Yeah. Every song nearly he wrote that had a number to it. Hobo Bill number so and so.
Okay.
And California Blues, I remember it was number four.
Yodel number four. Yodel, yeah.
Blue yodel number four. Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember that's the only one that I remember that he had, you know, the numbers to him and everything.
A fellow named John Fogerty, who was a singer, guitar player, main songwriter in Creedence Clearwater Revival. When Creedence Clearwater Revival broke up, he did a country album where he played everything himself. And California Blues Yodel Number 4 was one of the songs he did. Yeah, it was nothing but, you know, covers of old country songs. He did
Fogerty, that. Fogerty wasn't really, I mean, he was rock, but he wasn't like, I mean, he was kind of.
Yeah, Jimmy recorded that in 1929.
I'll be damned. That's good stuff.
The last song he recorded is what he died with, TB Blues.
Yeah, he had tuberculosis.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's neat. That is so neat. Well, so what? You've seen a lot of musical trends come and go, I would imagine. And in country music, what era would you say you like and appreciate the most?
Western swing.
Western swing. At Bob Wills stuff.
Bob Wills, yeah.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys.
Yeah.
Would you care to do one of those songs?
Do one of those.
I'd like to say this. You're talking about different trends and everything.
Sure.
I played a job with Jerry Lee Lewis back in 1953 over at Saxton. He was just getting started.
Oh, that is so cool. It is so neat that we have somebody who's such a part of music history in this town and has been around other music history.
And we're sitting next to him.
And we're sitting next to him, we're talking to him, and we're jamming with him.
Heck yeah.
That's too cool. So we're going to do us a Bob Wills tune?
Western swing.
All right.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old San Antonio. We're in dreams. I live with a memory beneath the stars all alone. It was there I found beside the Alamo enchantments change as the blue up above for that moonlit path. Only she would know. Still hears my broken song of love. Moon in all your splendor knows only my heart. Roll back my rose, rose of sand and tone. Lips so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart. Speak once again of my love, my own old broken song. Empty words I know still live in my heart alone. For that moon path by the Alamo and rose, my rose of San Antonio.
falling apart. Think once again of my love, my own old broken song. Empty words I know still live in my heart all alone. For that moonlit path by the Alamo and rode my road of San Antone. And rode my road of San Antone.
Yeah! Oh, man.
It's good stuff.
Oh, that is so cool. Did, back then, did you ever get the opportunity to see Bob Wills live?
No, I never did get to see him live or anything.
Yeah. That would have been a real treat if you had, though.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that. Who were some other, you know, just some of those country and western swing bands back then? Who were some other ones that were...
Well, Hank Thompson had a band later on. He was kind of a western swing band, Hank Thompson was.
Yeah.
He recorded a song that Chuck Harding from Kennett was playing down there. He wrote the song and everything that... Hank Thompson recorded it.
Oh, yeah?
It was Honky Tonk Girl.
Do you know that one?
Well, I used to know it.
You reckon you could play it?
I hope so. I'll try.
And also, by the way, just so anybody listening knows, these are songs that we haven't sat down and said, okay, let's put an arrangement to these. I'm following you. I'm trying to figure out what key you're in and then trying to pluck out some guitar leads.
You're handicapped, but I'm not, because I played drums with this guy.
Yeah.
I played my first gig with him when I was 11, playing drums.
Oh, my goodness. Now, I have to ask, what do you think of Roger doing his rock and roll and heavy metal, hair metal type stuff?
Well, he can do any kind.
Yeah,
he can do any kind. And
we're good at what we do.
They are good at what they do.
Yes, sir. I agree.
They are really good at what they do. Yeah. And I've tried to help them and tell them things, and some of the things they listen to me, most time they don't.
Did I ever listen?
No.
What was Roger like growing up? Was he a pretty good boy?
You have to bring that.
Okay. He did a head movement, which tells me he does not want to talk about that.
Hell no. That wasn't a no, that was a hell no.
That was a hell no.
So I was all right, wasn't I?
I think your dad's going to plead the fifth on that one.
You're not going to answer that one?
Uh-uh.
Yeah, uh-uh. Uh-uh. Oh, this is fun.
I tell you where he was, Jerry. If I whip him for something that he'd done.
Yeah.
I had to whip him in to make him hush crying, because he just kept getting madder and madder, and his face just turned as red as fire and everything.
That sounds like, I used to laugh at
my temper.
Shit spanked me.
His temper. He's getting madder and madder and madder all the
time. He's a pretty even-keeled guy now. I don't know what kind of meds Heather's got him on, but he's pretty even-keeled guy.
I've grown up. How about that?
I don't know what meds. I've had to do some of that myself.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did, he started me out in the old square dances here.
Oh, neat.
Playing drums and square dances. Well, no, actually, we started out the old West 60 Club. I was about 11, wasn't I? 11 or 12?
I don't remember just exactly how old he was. Yeah, we did the Puxico Homecoming. We'd done the Puxico Homecoming 4 years in a row.
Yep. Oh, be dang.
For the square dances.
I guess if tired of playing that same beat, they'd dance for hours, I'd play one hand and I'd switch. I guess my arms would just feel like they were jello.
Wow.
I mean, they would dance for literally hours.
Could have been polka.
Well, it's almost the same beat, isn't it? I mean, it's close.
So what song are we going to do here, Mr. Mattingly?
Well, you said something about the Hank Thompson song.
Yes, sir.
So I've got...
Looks like we're
trying
to
do that
C there. So.
C chord.
All right.
I'll try to do that one that Chuck Harding recorded, you know, and everything.
Okay.
Don't be fooled by big blue eyes, by a smile or a golden curl. She will love you now and then break every vow, for she there will be another in her arms tomorrow night. Hearts to her are toy tops, she likes to watch them twirl, for she's just a honky-tonk girl.
Just three chords, but they make the most out of them. And a guy like me, at the end of the song, I sing a harmony with you, even I've never heard that song before. I like songs where you can do that. I just love that. It, to me, and especially if you're even just kind of starting out in music, those are great songs to learn. And you will always go back to them, too.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, he don't just do three chords when he.
Oh, absolutely not. I'm just saying that particular song, that particular one is. That's one of the things I love. Like, I like '60s country, the swinging. I like those shuffle beats, you know. Mm-hmm. Songs like Crazy Arms or several. I love Buck Owens. Of course, that's not a shuffle beat, but. What was that Wynn Stewart song we did? It's such a pretty world. That's a beautiful song.
You want to do that one?
Absolutely I do.
C chord. It's such a pretty world today. Love it, the sunshine. Today and every day. It's such a pretty world today, knowing that you're mine, and happiness is being close to you. Though the rain may fall, skies will all be blue. If I look close enough, the sun will come shining through. It's such a pretty world today. Look at the sunshine. Today and every day since I met you. Thank you. the sun will come shining through. It's such a pretty world today. Look at the sunshine today and every day since I met you. Today and every day since I met you.
No wind. He was from Bakersfield area, right?
I believe
he was from that California Bakersfield, you know, the Buck Owens area. Another great California country artist is obviously Merle Haggard. Yeah. Now, a lot of people think, oh, he sang Okie from Muskogee. He must be from Oklahoma. Yeah. He's a California guy, you know. And he was heavily influenced by Lefty Frizzell. Do you happen to know any Lefty songs? Maybe Saginaw, Michigan, or...
No, I used to do some Lefty songs back in the 50s, but...
That was back in the 50s.
I can't really recall any right offhand. I haven't got my songbook with me, right? My titles that right.
That's all right.
Yeah, he's got a song. Well, you've seen it.
Yeah, I've seen it. It's got this hundreds of songs. How about, what about old Willie? You ever do any Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain, or...?
Well, I used to do part of it.
Okay.
D chord, I think, is what I do.
Okay.
In the twilight glow, I see her. Blue eyes crying in the rain. Where oh.
That was great. Oh, man.
You didn't sing it like Willie.
Now my hair has turned to silver.
Oh, man, my hair has turned to silver.
So's mine. It's getting there.
Mine's getting there, too.
Yeah, he's 92.
He's 92 and he's got more hair on his head than I do. That ain't fair, man. Now, did you ever try to write songs? Did you ever put pen to paper?
I've tried. I couldn't. I could get started off on one, and I couldn't.
Yeah.
Couldn't go.
I've been there.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, I was just there the other night.
Well, I just started singing the other people's songs.
There you go. Hey, if you have fun doing it.
Oh, yeah.
And you can get paid doing it.
Yeah.
Do it.
Do it.
Just do it.
In 1952. Of course, I was playing 7 nights a week Sunday afternoon, but I was banking $100 a week playing music.
Wow.
That was money back then.
Sure.
'52.
'52.
Yeah, how much was a car back then? $800 tops?
Well, no, they were in the 50s. They were, what, about 4,000?
My brother bought a brand new Ford pickup, and I think it was 48 that he bought a brand new Ford pickup. And got it for
$900.
Yeah.
Of course, you know, there wasn't a lot of extra fixtures on it or anything like that.
Now try to buy a brand new Ford pickup and see what you pay for it.
Oh, sweet.
It ain't $900, that's for sure. What does that make the payment, maybe?
$900 won't even get you a vehicle that runs, hardly. That'll be $900 for the wheels.
For the air and the tires.
Yeah.
And that truck registered 100 miles an hour. It would do 98.
And I bet it felt like it was going to fall apart, didn't it? So you're still gigging, right?
You're still playing out.
I play at Twin Towers over there twice a month.
That's cool.
Second and fourth Friday.
I hope I'm still gigging at 92 years old, man.
I hope I make it to 92.
You've changed your habits a little bit, Jerry. You're going to make it.
Yeah, I should.
What else you got over there?
Here's another Hank Thompson song. I like this song. I sang it a whole lot and everything. You know. G chord, fellas.
All right.
Now who left the door to heaven open? Who turned her head for a moment? Who told you that my heart was broken? And who left the door to heaven? That's why they sent you to me from above. And I know someone must have heard me crying and sent me such an angel that I love. Now who left the door to heaven open? Thank you. Who told you that my heart was broken? And who left the door to heaven open? Yeah, who left the door to heaven open?
I think Metallica should cover that song. I'd like to hear James Hetfield sing that.
I'd like to hear him pick it like you did. I don't think he can do it.
Please. Roger, you got a song you want to sing?
You'll make me sing again? Let's see.
One thing I wanted to say about these songs that we're playing. Not one of them has mentioned going down a dirt road, drinking beer with a girl in her tight pants.
And on a tailgate.
These songs are about romance and love. You know, loving a woman so much, you think she's from heaven.
Yeah.
Like that. That.
About heart over mind.
Okay. You remember where you're doing?
I think right there. I love
you so much that I can't leave you. Even though my mind tells me I should, and just about the time I think it's over, you come back and my leaving does no good. You got me heart over mind, worried all the time, knowing
type guys. I honestly do not know, but I have heard the song.
I always thought Ray did that song, but he didn't.
You want me to tell you who that?
Yes.
Mel Tillis.
Mel Tillis. There you go.
Yeah, how many Mel Tillis songs do you know? You know any
Southern
Mel
Tillis? Rain blowing like a gulf. Yes,
you didn't learn any Mel stuff?
No, that's one I never did learn. Back when I was getting all the songs and everything, he wasn't... He wasn't singing much.
Was some Hank Snow. You know any Hank Snow
today? I'm moving on. Gotta move along. You know any of them old trucker songs? Like, girl on the side of the road on the billboard.
You got one. I know one. He's fixing to sing. You'll know it.
I may,
yesterday,
not, may not know it all. I don't know. It's been so long since I do a little bit. Keep them wheels a rolling. I ain't got no time to lose. Keep them wheels a rolling. I ain't got no time to lose. I got a low down feeling. Truck driver's blues.
It's a good one, you know it?
He used to do it.
Got a little bit of that Route 66.
I know who wrote it.
Who wrote it?
Smiley Burnett.
Oh my goodness. Well, you gotta love a guy named Smiley, yes. Right?
Smiley.
I'm gonna change my name to Smiley Foster. Smiley. Welcome to another edition of the Smiley Foster SEMO Music and Arts Podcast.
I know you used to do it. I used to play it.
Yep. I can't even remember what key I do on it. I think I do it in G where I do it. If you ever plan to motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kick on Route 66. It winds from Chicago to L.A. 2,000 miles all the way. Get your kicks on Route 66. First you go through St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, Oklahoma City. Looks mighty pretty, you'll see. Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Pomona, Kingland, Barstow, San Bernardino. Won't you give help to that kind of tip when you make that California trip? Get your kicks on Route 66.
I'm sure, don't we?
Oh, yeah. However long you want to do this one, it don't matter. This is kind of a singing. Sound like a regular podcast. So.
No, this is not the typical podcast, but Roger did tell me a story, and you were telling it on the way over, and I would love to hear people who play music.
Yeah.
I would absolutely love for them to hear you talk about how you would select songs when you were out playing in the clubs and bars and whatnot.
Yeah, tell everybody how you
kind of came up with a song or two that you thought the crowd would like. I think this is the neatest thing.
I would mostly go to, if it was a new club and if I'd never played in it before, I'd go to the jukebox and see how many songs was on the jukebox that I knew. And I would sing them, and I'd also listen to what they were playing on the jukeboxes.
Yeah.
If I knew them songs, I would sing them for the crowd.
And if you didn't, you'd have it by the next time you played there.
The next time I played there, yeah.
That's so cool.
And that is brilliant. People need to take notes.
They need to take notes. Like if I go in and I'm hearing all Bon Jovi on the jukebox, I'm going
to
walk out.
Guess what? I need to learn.
You're going
to
walk out.
Yeah, you're going to walk out. No kidding. You say you're going to walk out.
You're not.
Right? You'll be back doing I'm a Cowboy on a Steel Horse I Ride.
Yeah.
On a Steel Horse I Ride. So what would a typical song, and of course I know you played many times, but what is a song that was played on the jukebox pretty regularly that you remember?
Here's one that Tennessee Ernie Ford come out with. He had a recording of this one back in the 50s.
Okay.
About a G chord.
All right.
There, standing in the corner with my barrel so straight, I look out the window and over the gate. The big fat rabbits were jumping in the grass. Wait till they hear them all shotgun blast. Shotgun boogie, I done saw your track. Look out, Mr. Rabbit, when I caught my hammer back. The hickory nuts so big you could see them in the dark. The big fat squirrel, they scratch and they fight. I'll be on that ridge before daylight with the shotgun boogie. All I need is one shot. Look out, Bushy Tail, tonight you'll be in the pot. Well, I made a little and down, said, boy, this is love. We headed for the brush to shoot a big fat dove. Shotgun boogie, more the feathers flew. Look out, beat on you. I sat down on the log and took her on my lap. She said, wait a minute, bud, you gotta see my map. Got a 16 gauge deep down like a rifle. He don't like a man that's gone on a trifle. Shotgun boogie.
I know it's probably getting to be about 7 o'clock or so. I'm not sure what time it is.
I got
7:11.
10 after 7.
10 after 7.
Yeah.
But I do reckon if it's all right with you, if we could do one more. And I also want to wish you a happy Father's Day.
Thank you.
I lost my dad a couple years ago, and I can guarantee you he would be eating this up. He would have been right in the middle of this, singing songs with us. So this just tickles me to death, man.
I wanted Roy here, Ward, but he had family come in. But
does not have to be the last time we do this.
Oh no, it's not going to be. We're going to get Roy. I know he's going to listen to this. Roy Ward, you're going to bring your butt here and play.
Absolutely.
It'll be fun.
You know, it's funny. I hear all these guys talking about, oh, I like old country, and they couldn't name one of these songs, you know. I couldn't see Ernie Ford. Who's that? You know.
You say Hank Snow, and they're like, well, I know a Hank Sr., but who's a Hank Snow?
Hank Snow, Canadian country
artist. Yep.
Hank Snow was the quintessential Canadian country artist, and of course you got Stompin' Tom Connors, it's Bud the Spud in the Bright Red Mud. I don't know how many Americans know him.
Little Jimmy Dickens, how many songs you know his you know?
Oh, Lord, probably a good half a dozen or more.
That's great. It would be an absolute, I want to go ahead and we're going to wrap it up with this last song here. Okay. But I would be absolutely thrilled if we could end this on a Buck Owens tune.
All right. A chord.
All right.
You want a slow one or a fast one?
A fast one.
That's
a
fast one. G.
Gotcha.
There's a place down the street we call Sam's Place. Things start jumping every evening when the sun goes down. There's gonna be a party down at Sam's Place. That's where the game goes. Shaking Tina, hails Pasadena, always got a big smile on her face. There's old Hoochie Coochie Hattie, she comes from Cincinnati, and there's always a party at Sam's Place. Thank you.
blocks away, playing country music down at Sam's Place, from setting sun until the break of day. There's old Simmy Shank and Tina, hail Pasadena, always got a big smile on her face. There's old Hoochie Coochie Hattie, comes from Cincinnati, and there's always a party at Sam's Place. And I'll see you tonight at Sam's Place.
I like that ending, all three of them.
Oh man, that was great. Well, fellas, that's going to wrap it up for this edition of the Jerry Foster SEMO Music and Arts Podcast. It has been an absolute honor and a pleasure.
It's been a hoot.
And if the good Lord's willing and the cricks don't rise, we'll do it again.
Oh, yeah.
But I'd like to thank my guest. I apologize. The first name again?
Deward.
Mr. Deward Mattingly. And of course, his son, Roger Mattingly of Cinder Block. And I'm Jerry. Like to thank everybody for listening in, who has stuck with us and enjoyed this time with us. This has been very, very enjoyable. And until next time, sayonara!